Thank you. It would be beautiful, but you're too scared to get used to it. One day you'll be alone. It's hard to accept, too sad to bear. Because the happiness of tomorrow daydreams to forget the unhappiness of today. And when this moment arrives, it's hard to gather the strength to start over on your own. I would have rather been this way from the start, for being forgotten is worse than dying.
Thank you. Thank you. controlling the flow of an already too experienced mouth. The dream of a better tomorrow. The fear of suffocation in a sudden goodbye breath. From the palm of my hand, I watched the stellar journey of an eyelash maneuvering in the air, propelled by a wistful hesitant breath, with anxious longing, but completely immobile, fully aware of its impending fall into the abyss. Yet I follow that eyelash as it floats ominously downward, with desperate desire hurled against the earth, with expectation of new life, of transformation. Barren earth will speak rather than remain silent. Like a seed that dies when it sprouts, unlike a grenade that obliterates everything in its path. That minute interval between two hemispheres, that coordinate point where two unilateral concepts touch each other in a way seemingly contradictory. That moment of waiting to sense the fusion of eyelash with parched ground, resignation or liberation, both words combine into a single sound. Almost incomprehensible until I hear the eclosion of desire, a heart-wrenching but necessary birth.